to be carried home by you. Sailing down along the coast of High Harbory. Broadside they fought all on the main. Blow high, blow low, and so sailed we. Until at last the frigate shut the pirates' mast away. Sailing down along the coast of High Harbory. With cutlass and gun, hold fought for hours three. Blow high, blow low, and so sailed we. The ship, it was their cabin, and their grave, it was the sea. Sailing down along the coast of High Harbory.
Trim the yards off the wind!
Why, look! It's the bastard son of the late William Kidd. Still a mere boy, and yet 10 times the demon his father was.
Fancy seeing you here, Kenway. Still looking sleek and mean. Did you steal that costume from a dandy in Havana?
No, sir. I found this on a corpse. One that was walking about and talking shite to my face only moments before.
Huh.
So, what's this I hear about a planned raid on a plantation? Not keeping secrets from me, are you?
Not very well. Every day, schooners packed with sugar sail past, coming from plantations nearby. Most times they stop here, sell off a few crates. There's one man visiting today that'd earn you a fine profit. So if you'd like to rob his plantation, I'll point him out.
I would. Is it a Mr. Beckford that owns this plantation?
That's the man. He owns dozens round these islands. And he's bloody rich.
Just the sort I like to see robbed.
His agent is around here somewhere. Find and follow him, and he'll lead you straight to your prize.
Yes. We trade at prices Mr. Beckford nuts are fair, and with a quality he knows is sound.
Like his hearty molasses and raw cane, that's a given.
It gladdens me to hear you're saying so. But despite the waywardness of your enterprise here, I understand that you are men of discernment.
Shake us so simply.
Beaufort, Manning, to me. We've done with this place.
Aye, sir. What's our course?
We'll return to the plantation and there take stock of our inventory. It was a good harvest this year.
You might not talk so loud, sir. This isn't anything like a friendly port, Ken.
Nonsense, man. I had a delightful conversation with a chap just now. We came to the front and the planet.
As you see, sir.
All right and unfurl, boys. We're going home.
Hold you!
Thank you.
up and unfurl, boys. We're going home.
The look of a man crafting a bold idea. A look I've seen before.
You mark well, Ade. I've just overheard one of the Beckford's men talking grandly about his plantation and all the cargo he's keeping there, and it gave me the idea that I might take these goods off him and sell them off for a better price than he'd ever ask.
Ah, a man of vision. I like this idea. I see them.
Clifford, stand up, Captain.
Douse the royal toss. Get them aloft. Douse all sail.
Struts up with a will.
Loose and trim to.
Aloft, lads. Check those royals.
This man's working for Peter Beckford's people. Do you know them? The Beckfords and their sugar empire.
Aye. Beckford's and the Draxes. I never worked their plantations, but I knew their names from hearing other men use them.
But you worked the plantation.
Crowd in all on!
This man's working for Peter Beckford's people. Do you know them? The Beckford's and their sugar empire.
Aye. Beckford's and the Draxes. I never worked their plantations, but I knew their names from hearing other men use them.
But you worked the plantation, no?
A modest one, aye. As a striker in the boiling house.
Boiling house? Was it water they boiled, or something else?
Cane juices. It's a hard process making sugar. Dangerous. Must be why it fetches such a dear price.
What's it like, toiling on a plantation day and night?
Well, with the cane sugar cut and harvested, it's run between two metal rollers across the juice from the plant. After collecting the juice, it was time to boil away the waters from the sugar. This we did in Thatcher's mill. Let me tell you, brother, boiling sugar is near the hottest thing on earth. Just a touch on the skin will stick like birdlime and burn on, leaving a terrible scar.
Jesus.
Starboard, castaway, adrift in the road.
It's a risk to anchor too close. Soldiers roving the plantation would catch us for sure.
Drop here then and sneak ashore. We'll look after the jackal.
Here? Why such disarray?
Bit of a do, sir, that's all. It's Wilmington's birthday.
And you saw fit to get nickeled on duty. You saw fit to get nickeled on duty.
No bother, sir. We've everything sorted.
We'll soon see, won't we? For you must double the watch this evening.
Double, sir? Whatever for?
I believe I was followed here, young man. By pirates, if my eyes are on me, though the ship was uncommonly large for such rascals. Certainly wasn't slavers, though, not a ship that size. In any case, double the watch. And keep your damned eyes wide for anything suspicious. You up there! Look alive, man! You've a job to do!
Apologies, sir. I'll keep my eyes peeled.
For God's sake, what the hell is going on here today? How do you suppose you'll be able to ring that alarm if you're piss drunk and barely able to stand?
Forgive me, sir. I am fit and able. If I see any strangeness about, you'll hear the bell ringing straight away, I promise.
I'd like to speak to the man in charge here. I require entrance to the warehouse. Which of you dogs has the key to the warehouse, huh?
Take kindly to broken goods.
The key, goddammit! Someone find me the key!
Is there no one sober here?
Fetch me the warehouse key, if you please.
Oi!
At least he keeps the packets in plumb with Victor. It warms the heart.
You, stop!
Trespasser, take him down!
You're in the shrubs, out!
No.
Don't kill me! Please! Mercy!
Intruder! I need some help here! Intruder! Help!
Too much action.
One of them, whoever they are.
We all want to get to our point. The bastard won't take kindly to both. What was that, Jones? Keep to the task in hand.
You can curse me later. Now you work.
Fish in a barrel, mate.
What?
We've a bush thing.
Thank you.
Captain has the helm.
Unfold, mates! Let's move!
Here's to our pirate republic, lads. We're prosperous and free and out the reach of kings, clergy, and debt collectors.
Near 500 men now pledge their allegiance to the Brethren of the Coast in Nassau. Not a bad number.
True. Yet we lack sturdy defenses. If the king were to attack the town, he'd trample us.
Then let us find the observatory. If it does what these Templars claim, we'll be unbeatable.
Not that twaddle again, can we? It's a story for schoolboys. I mean, proper defenses. Steal a galleon, shift all the guns to one side. And make a nice ornament for one of our harbors.
It will not be easy to steal a full Spanish galleon. Have you one in mind?
I do, sir. And I'll show you. She's a fussock, she is. Fat and slow.
Get the mains!
Your jackdaw handles knives. Pinster from the Spanish, was it?
Aye. In the midst of a hurricane.
Just before the treasure fleet was smashed against the shore.
Was the haul aboard as rich as men are saying?
1,000 times that. I reckon £1,000,000 worth of reals was sunk that day.
Devil love a hurricane. Might have a dive there one day. See what we can rummage up.
Diving them wrecks would be a nice change of pace for us. No need for violent actions against merchants and such.
Well, that's some soft talk coming from a pirate. And as it happens, I mostly agree. We'll save the clashing of cutlasses for the military. And them that get in our way. Easy as she goes. No telling what you may find out here.
Like staring through a waterfall.
Don't soil your breeches, lads. I got this.
A monster, look at the size of her.
Aye, and we'd not last long face to face with her. Hear that, Kenway? Keep your distance. We'll strike when fortune favors us.
The cover of darkness, most likely.
Aye, it may come to that.
We're clipped.
Down's off!
Charles. Reckless as they come.
An old friend of yours?
Not a man I call a friend. But we've been doing this kind of work for so long, I can't help but respect them.
Sailing for that island.
I know the place. A natural stronghold used by a French captain named Ducasse.
Julian Ducasse, the Templar.
Name's right. Didn't know he had a title.
I know the man. And if he sees my ship, he'll know it from his time in Havana, meaning he may wonder at who's sailing her now. I can't risk that.
And I don't want to lose that galleon. Let's think on't. And maybe wait till it's dark before hopping aboard.
Sails! Loose up!
Crowd on all the sail we have!
Now you're ready to sail for the war. Sail, roll, and go.
Water devil, sir! We will be dragged down to our deaths, Captain!
Spanish ladies, farewell and adieu to you ladies of Spain, for we've received orders for to sail for old England, and we may never see
you again.
We'll rant and we'll roar like true. Every man drink off his full bumper. Now let every man drink off his full glass. We'll drink and be jolly and drown.
Gentlemen! As is custom among our kind, we do not plunge headlong into folly on the orders of a single madman, but act according to our own collective madness. The object of our attention is a square-rigged galleon, and we want her for the advantage she'll bring Nassau. So I'll put it to the vote. All those in favor of storming this cove and taking this ship, stomp and shout aye!
Aye!
Those who oppose, whimper nay.
Never was the King's Council so unified. Thank you.
¡Tú, detente! ¡Tu vida ha terminado!
¿Es algo? Si sientes curiosidad, ¿por qué no miras tú?
Remember the gift you gave me? Well, it answers just fine.
Fils de putain! As bold as a musket ball, and still half as sharp!
I'm sorry about this, mate, but I can't risk you telling your Templar friends about me still kicking around.
I pity you, Boucanier. After all you have seen, after all we showed you of our order, still you embrace the life of an ignorant and aimless rogue!
What's this?
Is petty larceny the extent of your ambition? Have you no mind to comprehend the scope of ours? All the empires on Earth abolished, a free and open world, without parasites like you! Que l'enfer que tu trouveras soit le fruit de ton insouciance.
The cove is ours!
I just saw you were logging out, so I thought I'd stop by and give you something. A little welcome gift. We give awards to our top-notch employees for doing quality work. And they're nice to have, since there's no official bonus scheme here. I already have about 11 or so. Oh. Bonjour. Of course. I'll pass it on. Well, looks like Olivier wants to meet with you. It's exciting. Follow me. It's on the top floor, so it's not hard to find. But the rest of this building can be confusing to first-timers, so we had the tools team whip up a great map application. Check your communicator. I added a waypoint to Olivier's office. Should be easy to find. Olivier's a nice guy. He won't bite.
Your animus. I'm sort of the Scotty of this Abstergo Enterprise, in charge of all the techie stuff. Do you have a minute? Oh, damn it. The tracker says you're on your way to Olivier's office. Ah, all right. I'll ping you when you're done. I have a favor to ask.
Bonjour. Go right in. He's waiting for you.
Well, unless you are specifically ordering me to abandon it, I won't jeopardize our flagship project. Edward Kenway is the... But this is how Hollywood got its start, right? With pirate movies. Douglas Fairbanks, Errol Flynn, and now we have access to the real deal.
Wait. Exactly.
We'll talk about all that together at the show. Right. So I reviewed some of your data. Pretty raw stuff. Obviously, we need to scrub off some of the dirt to make it family-friendly. Maybe give Edward a voice like James Bond or something. More of a ladies' man. A beautiful city, no? So the main reason I asked you here concerns something called the observatory. It's been mentioned a few times in the footage you found. I'd like to encourage you to focus on locating this specific set of memories as soon as possible. If it were up to me, on s'en crisse. I wouldn't bother. But some bigwigs at Abstergo Industries have been hounding me for days. So, follow whatever leads you find, and hopefully we can... Oh, incoming call. I have to take this. We'll keep in touch. Bonne journée. Alan, bonjour.
Oui, 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 tout va bien. Naturellement.
Hi, John from IT again. You got a second? Good. I'm adding a waypoint to your map. So, a colleague of yours left for vacation this morning and forgot to send a video file she promised me. Since I hate just about everyone else on your floor, I was hoping you could help me. Could you transfer the file from her computer and deliver it to the courier when she comes? It'll be easy. You just wander over to their Animus, log in, and transfer the file. Easy. And please be snappy before I find a reason to hate you, too.
These rules for no reason.
Yeah.
A locked door. Not a problem. That's the advantage of me having level one security clearance. Now, you do, too. Don't abuse it. Log on, and I'll walk you through this. The core to find the data inside. Once you reach it, your communicator will download it automatically. You need to find your way around the core to reach the data inside. You cracked it. Good. The file should be downloading. I set up a database for any data you find. Just look for the My File section in your communicator, and you'll be redirected right away. Everything you download will be found in there. Protected by a firewall, of course.
December 23rd, 2012. Sample Recovery Unit Team Lead Fisher Case reporting on Subject 17, Desmond Miles. The subject was deceased and unattended. Time of death was placed.